So I was born and raised in Talladega, and when I was 10 years old, we started visiting First Baptist Church in Talladega, and that was the first time I had ever heard a pipe organ in person. And I went up to meet the organist afterwards, being the precocious 10-year-old that I was, and I just wanted to know more about it. And the organist there, Mike Burt, took a liking to me and started introducing me to the instrument, showing me a little bit about how to read music. And after about a year or so of that, he introduced me to a local piano teacher who, through the experience of being able to then study piano privately, I was introduced to Dr. Faith Fries at the University of Alabama when I started in the community music school program. So I did that for 4 years, competed in and won the University of Alabama Organ Scholarship Competition, and then I spent my 4 years at Alabama and received a Bachelor of Music degree in organ performance. But now, you know, in 2021, we rarely hear of people studying privately. So for the students that live on campus, they have this unique opportunity to be able to study privately with a very skilled teacher for free. And when you think about the larger families that have 5 children or so, it's so cost prohibitive.
I came here about, it'd be 6 years, came from a domestic violence relationship. So I came here to the home. Piano became available as an option 4 years ago. I have the 4 kids that are playing now. They enjoy it, you know. It's a lot of benefits to piano. Gives them something to do, of course, other than math or science or reading and video games especially. But I was excited when it was offered because, you know, again, it gives them something to do. They look forward to the competitions that they have, and they enjoy when they're asked to perform. And if I had to pay for it, private lessons, I couldn't. I mean, I couldn't. And I was looking for something for my kids to do being here. And again, it wasn't many options. So when that came available, I was really, really glad and blessed to have the opportunity.
Thanks to the generosity of donors and of the home, that the children that live on campus are able to experience that wonderful education at no cost to them. So it's an honor to be able to work with the junior board of the Presbyterian Home for Children, and just to marvel and be able to participate in the work that they do with children, not only in the Talladega area, but across the state. From an academic standpoint, we focus so much on STEM programs, and in Alabama in particular, it's a shame that the arts seem to be cut from the budget every year. But art is one of the things that links us back to our heritage of any kind. It's how we understand the culture. So having an arts education available is something that so many students in Alabama aren't privileged to experience. But here through the Presbyterian Home for Children, they have this unique opportunity that is so wonderful. And to members of the community or anyone who's looking to donate to any sort of program, just with the sheer academic value of what the students are getting here, not just in math and science, but also in the arts. It's a way that this program is enriching the lives of students, and by enriching their lives culturally, they will in turn become very productive citizens that are contributing to the health of the state and this nation as a whole.